Now, let me ask you a very simple question. Is fixed deposit actually a good way of investing your money in today's date? The answer is no. So in this video, I'm going to explain to you why fixed deposit is not a good way of investing your money, and also what is the best alternative where you can actually invest your money, which is a safe and guaranteed return of almost 8% to 14% per year. Now, a majority of us Indians, we love fixed deposit and we like it for three main reasons. First, we think that we are getting a decent return. We think a 5.5% or a 6% return is actually a good return, right? Second reason is because the guaranteed return. Because the bank is guaranteeing you a certain amount of money at the end of the year, we think, okay, fine, you know what? It's a guaranteed return, so it's a good way of investment. And the third and the main reason is because we think it's a safe investment. We know that when we're giving our money to the bank, it's completely safe. So there are three main reasons why we Indians, we love fixed deposit. But is it actually a good way of investing? The answer is no, purely because every year you have inflation which is happening. If you see last year, in 2020, the inflation rate in India is about 6.2%. Now, at a 6.2% rate, inflation rate, plus you have your capital gain tax. So if you're investing in fixed deposit, whatever capital gains which is happening, you will have a tax on it. So if you take into consideration your inflation with your capital gain tax, you're actually not making any profit on your fixed deposit. You might as well lose money, or you're trying to keep up with the inflation rate. Now, if I'm actually telling you there are other sorts of investment which can give you a guaranteed return of 7% to 14%. Yeah, absolutely. Guaranteed return, right? So that's the main keyword. So if you're able to make a 7% to 14% guaranteed return, which is much higher than what a fixed deposit gives, wouldn't you be interested in that? The absolute answer is yes. And these investments are your bonds and debentures. Now, I know at first you'll be like, bonds and debentures, it sounds very confusing, it sounds very hard, it sounds very complicated, but it's actually not. So in this video, I'm going to help you understand what are bonds and debentures, how to invest in bonds and debentures, and which platform to use. And finally, before investing in them, what are the basic things that you need to check so that you can make sure that you are investing into a good bond or a good debenture. So make sure you watch the video till the end. Now, the first question is, what are bonds? What are debentures? Now, let me explain to you by giving you a very simple example. Let's say that you are running a business right now. Now, you want to grow your business. You want to scale your business. For that, you need money. Now, there are three easy ways that you can actually get this money. The very first way is that you can go to a bank, take a loan from the bank. But in this case, you will have to pay a hefty interest to the bank for the loan which you have taken. The second option is that you can go to the stock market and make your company public, provided that you're meeting the criterias. In this case, you're giving a portion or you're giving a ownership of your company because you're giving shares to the public, right? So you're giving a small ownership of your company out there to the people itself. Third way is that you can go to retail investors like me, or you can go to institutional investors like your mutual funds or hedge funds and take money from these people. Now, the third way is slightly more easier because when you're taking money from retail investors or institutional investors, the amount of interest which you will have to pay back to them is much lesser as compared to what you will have to pay to the bank. So naturally, a lot of companies prefer the third option. And this document, which basically states that you, when you're taking this particular amount of money as a company, have to pay a certain amount of interest to these retail investors, is what we call a bonds or debentures. Now, I know the first question which you will have in your mind is, can any company actually issue a bond or a debenture? The answer is no. There are certain requirements for it. And the companies which actually do this are actually large companies, like big companies. Now, the company can either be a private company or a government company. If it's a government company, then it's called a bond. If it's a private company, like a private bank or any other private company, then it's called a debenture. This is the very simple difference between a bond and a debenture. Now, we have actually understood what are bonds, we have understood what are debentures, and we have also understood why companies are issuing these bonds or debentures. Now, the big question being, why you as an investor should invest in these companies? The answer is very simple, because they're giving you a fixed guaranteed return, which is actually higher than your fixed deposit. The reason everyone loves fixed deposit is because of two simple words. It is fixed. It is guaranteed. Before I invest in fixed deposit, I know that I will be getting, let's say, 5.5% return or a 6% return. That assurity is what is the reason I invest in fixed deposit. And you're getting the same kind of a reason, or you're getting the same kind of assurity in these bonds or debentures. Before investing itself, you get to know that you're going to get 9% or 10% interest. So why not, right? It is actually a much better or a much easier way of investing your money than keeping it in your fixed deposit. Now, let's actually understand how to invest in bonds and debentures. Now, the very first thing is you need to have a DMAT account. If you still don't have a DMAT account, in that case, the links for opening a DMAT account is in the description below. Now, the platform name which we are going to use is GoldenPie. Now, it's actually a great platform. It has been invested by Zerodha and it is actually owned by Zerodha as well. So, definitely a trustable platform. Now, I know the first question which a lot of you will be asking is, bro, Nikhil, what is the commission charges? How much does the platform actually charge when I'm investing in, let's say, a bond? The answer is zero. The platform will not be charging any amount from you. The platform actually charges money from the companies that are issuing these bonds. So you don't have to worry about any commissions over here. When you invest, you don't have to pay any single amount. Now let's go through a few basic details just to understand how you can invest on GoldenPie. Now, once you are on this particular website, you will need to update your KYC documents. That is very important. Once you do that, then you can go to Discover Bonds section. Now, over here, you will see different kinds of bonds which are available. So, different kinds of bonds or different kinds of debentures which are available. Now, on the top itself, you can see a South Indian Bank. Now, a South Indian Bank is a private bank. So, this is a debenture, right? Now, you can see over here, it's a private sector bank. The minimum investment is about 2.2 lakh rupees, right? So that's a minimum amount which you need to put in this particular bond. Yield is basically your annual rate of return. So annually, you will be getting an interest rate of 13.28%, which is almost more than the double of what fixed deposits actually give you. The payment term is yearly. That means every year is when you get the payment. And the call date is basically your maturity date. So on 24th of Jan, 2025, this particular bond will be getting matured and you will be getting your principal amount back. Now, something which is very important for you to check is the credit rating. So over here, for example, you see the credit rating is A minus. Now, this credit rating is actually similar to your credit score. The banks actually issue you a credit score depending on how you are spending your credit card and everything. Similarly, these companies are also given a credit score based on certain key factors. And these credit scores are given by well-reputed companies, right? So they look into different things, like they look into payment history, they look into management quality, they look into performance of the company, or they look into multiple different aspects before actually giving these ratings. The list of ratings is actually added on the screen. So pause the video, take a screenshot, take a picture of it, and then continue watching it, right? So here we can see that the entire credit rating, which the South Indian Bank is A minus. So, lower the credit rating, the higher the risk is in terms of getting your money back. So, that is something which you need to know. So, A minus may or may not, depending on however you want to take the risk. I personally would not want to take the risk of A minus. So, I would look for something which is slightly more better. So, going down, for example, let's see. This is all A minus. You have double A over here, but the minimum investment amount is approximately 10 lakh rupees, which is quite high, right? If you go down, India Bulls, for example, is a credit rating of double A. Their minimum investment amount is only 2 lakh rupees. They're giving an yearly annual rate of interest at 9.3% and their maturity date is 2026. The payment term is yearly. Looks much better than what a fixed deposit is actually offering. So if you click over here, this will give you a little bit more detail in terms of every single aspect of it, right? So minimum amount, yield, maturity date, investment, and all the basic. It's a private company, like I mentioned before, so it's a debenture. And this entire amount will be taxable. And if you go down, it shows your credit rating, how safe it is or how not safe it is. How safe it is. So over here, like I mentioned, it's a double A, so it is a quite a safe credit rating or quite a safe debenture. And it also gives you basic highlights in terms of what the company is, how well is the company doing. What is the total annual revenue, every aspect of it. And it also gives you cash flow in terms of when you will be getting your money back if you're investing a certain amount of money over here. All you have to do is click on invest and that's pretty much it. So I hope you have actually understood what is the best alternative for fixed deposit, which can actually give you a guaranteed return of almost 8% to 14%. I hope you have actually understood what bonds are or what debentures are. And I hope you're not going to invest all your money into fixed deposit, but rather you're going to take a portion of your money and invest in bonds and debentures, because it will also help you diversify your portfolio. So if you did like this video, do like it, do subscribe, and I'll see you all in the next video.